Hey everybody, it's CybergWar. How are my favorite people doing? I'm at Area 18, and I am in a noob suit because this is my alternate account. Yay! I haven't used this account in like well over a year and a half. I didn't have a game package on it, and I won a game today. I won an X1, which came with a game package, which was really weird. Seeing how that's like a land vehicle, but I'm in the game, and the ship comes with The ship comes with an MR, Aurora MR, so you can actually get around. In the verse, they give you that ship with the land vehicle. It was I won it from CobraTV, who got it from CIG, so they gave me a Star Citizen digital game package. I guess the Aurora is like the loaner ship, so I can actually get around in the verse because you can't fly an X1 anywhere. And then it has lifetime insurance. So I figured I would start a zero to hero. I haven't done that in forever. I'm just going to be like down and out in Arclight. So this is all I got. Let's see how much money I have. 000. And all I have in is Aurora MR. Oh, I have stuff here. So we're not going to use any of this stuff. I have no credits. All I have is what you start out with, which is your Arclight pistol, one magazine, one MedPen, and a helmet. And then my Aurora MR. I'm going to go out and make my way in the verse. First thing I'm going to do is take call to arms because, you know, I'm going to be a badass bounty hunter with no weapon. All right. And then, oh, wow, this is going to be really tough. I just realized because the AI is super badass nowadays. First priority should be box mission, getting food, and making some money. So that's what I'm going to do. And looting armor. Looting armor, weapons, multi-tools, med pens, everything I'm gonna need. Everything I'm gonna loot. Hangar 3. Alright. Any of this stuff? Can I drink any of it? If it says drink. Oh, wait, this one. I'm taking it. It's got 40% liquid. See, I can scavenge anything I want. I just found a half-drinking bottle of Kool-Aid. I'm taking it. It's my survival. Someone else's backwash may be my only hope for survival out here in this harsh system. Oh my god, the Aurora. I think it was the second ship or the first ship I bought. It was the first ship I bought. Alright, here we go. Vehicle storage. Need to put the drink in there. Oh my god, the camera is so bad in the ship. It's so tiny. Alright, that's all I got inside. I always thought this was the coolest animation for getting in a ship. Just wiggle your butt in here. Sit down. I remember back in the day when I saw that, when they first introduced Star Citizen, my mind was blown. All right, let's find a mission and go do it. We're going to start with Kovalak's evaluation right here. We're going to go sell two, bring it back to 45 on Walla. How much is that? It's 3,000 credits. Ooh, that's going to be a nice little chunk of change for someone who's broke. Look at this bad boy. The blue paint's really popping. I like it. Ba, 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 look at all this fun. Okay. I'm just going to... This is going to take forever. Holy cow. I'm so used to just getting away and getting out of the planet's atmosphere and stuff. There we go. Sail 2, here we come, buddy. We're going to check all the loot boxes there. We're going to grab some food. There's not much storage in this ship. Hopefully there's some loot boxes there. I'm going to try and get some armor. Once I get at least a chest piece, I can probably go do a bunker. Cool thing about having this little ship, is you can just park anywhere. I'm so used to flying big ships or medium-sized ships that having a small ship is just like a luxury that you take for granted sometimes. Whew. All right, so let's hope the mission doesn't get bugged because I could use the 3,000 credits. See, I have nothing.
No, no money.
Nothing. First thing I want to do before I get the box is check all these buildings. I don't want to grab the box in case something happens. I'm going to go to the farthest building first and then work my way back to the ship. All right, there's nothing in here. All right, first place I go, nothing there. But I did find a bottle 40% full. Backwash. All right, let's go there. All right, vehicle spawn, checked. This is the storage and commodity building. I don't even have money to buy commodities here. Oh, wow. There's nothing here either. Oh, man. I better stop running everywhere. I don't have anything to drink other than that bottle. The more you run, the quicker you dehydrate. Oh, there's a red box. All right. The quicker you dehydrate and... All right. Armor. Arms and chest. I'll take that back with me, too. I can sell that. That's credits right there. Everything's gonna get sold. All right, multi-tool, we'll put that on. Take these other multi-tools, take all this stuff right there that I can sell. Every credit counts. I think I'm gonna store all this stuff at what is over Arcorp, Bajini Point, just so I'll have extra stuff there that I've looted and it doesn't get intermingled with my stuff at Area 18. So the only places I should be storing anything and pulling stuff out will be the space stations over the planets. That'll make it easy. You know, I can sell that medical attachment. There we go. Now I just need a set of legs and a backpack and a rifle and some ammo and some credits. So my advice to new players, when you're just starting out, don't go crazy. Don't spend any of your cash or whatever, your credits. Go out and loot. Go hit box missions. Loot everything you can at the moon bases that you can land at. The mining outposts, HDMS and Shubins and stuff like that. Don't go near the underground bunker facilities because you'll get shot at because you'll be trespassing. And then just go out and loot. Take everything that they have there. Oh, good. And sell as much of it as possible at the terminals. I think I got enough food for now. I can always get more. You can sell the stuff at space stations and at the cassava, at the shops, and make money. All right, let's have some legs.
Give me some legs.
You know, I could probably make like 30 to 50,000 on. Oh yeah, look at that, legs. Oh man, it's all coming together. I'm so fashionable. I could probably make 30 to 50,000 just hitting one moon, like Walla, which has a lot of moon bases. Taking everything there and looting it and selling it and still having food and everything left over and clothing and whatever. Like these outfits here, where is it? This outfit here, I can take that to Orison and get like 1400 credits for it. So I got two of those right there. That's gonna pay me almost as much as I'm doing this mission. I take those to Orison. This helmet will get really good money at the cargo decks on the space stations over the planets. These shoes go for 440 credits. The multi-tools probably don't go for anything because they're like subscriber flare multi-tools, so they're probably like one credit, but you can use them. I think the yellow ones you might get a little bit of money for, like 100 or 200 credits. I think it's like 200 to 300 credits. Food's not worth much, but the shoes, you know, they go anywhere from 60 to 400 credits, you know. This jacket, I have not found anywhere I could sell that jacket yet that makes any money. But, you know, these medical attachments, like I got over here, there's five of them. I think they're like 100 credits each. That's like 500 credits right there. So, you know, just like stuff like that. It all adds up, especially when you're broke. Medical gowns is another good source of money. You take those, put those in a local inventory at the station, go to the clothing store and sell them. You get 45 credits for each one. You know, that's the type of thing you do when you got no credits. And then you build up your little credit supply. I know this coat goes for like 600-700. I think if I take it out to Microtech, it'll actually go for more too. The different places have different values. Things have different value at different places, I should say. If I knew the Queen's English, I could talk probably. All right, we're out of here. Look at this. I got a whole armor outfit. I am freaking styling. Oh, I should put one of the tractor beams on my tractor beam. You just take it, drag it on down, or you can even double click on it and it'll go in there. And then now it's attached. And I don't have any medical, but I'm gonna put a flare on too. The pink flares go for like 18 credits each, I think. All right, I got a blue flare. Let's go. All right, next stop. Oh, package is here. I thought there was one more building, but here we go. We're gonna take this package. We have it. Don't drop it. At least try not to drop it, because it might get bugged out and you won't be able to deliver it and get paid for it. Did I hit all these buildings? Yeah, I did. Okay. All right, it's a small ship. There's not much room to put any cargo inside of it. There's a little bit of an inventory. All right, and we're just gonna set it down right here. You just left click on the ground and it'll go there. Wham bam. Close the door. I'm gonna open my ship inventory and bring all this stuff over. Look at that, we're 36% full. We're gonna go deliver this box and then we're gonna hit, what's the name, Bajini. We're gonna store stuff at Bajini, only take with us what we need, and we're gonna set our spawn there. There's no loot in here, but we're going to put this in the box. I hope so, buddy. I hope this works. Place it. I don't see the marker for the box, though. That's got me worried. Oh, it went through. We did it. Yay, we did it. We so did it. Yay. Oh, wrong button. We did it. Thanks, buddy. We're going to dance. We're going to do the dance. The dance of love. Made 3,000 credits. I'm not a broke joke. Oh, yeah. I got money. I got food. I got this cool armor. All right. Bye. And then while we're here, we're going to go hit all those other... Whoa! Guy in the C2 here. Coming in. We're going to go hit these other shops. What's he getting here? He's probably getting Laronite here. They sell Laronite and Barrel here at 45, so he's probably trying to fill up. He's going to make real money. Why is he just floating? The wind's blowing him around. Wow. Anything good here? Multi-tools, gloves, hats, mining utilities. I'm not going to take any more food. I think I have plenty for a while. But I'm going to take the stuff I can sell. I just took more food. Oh, well. It's okay. It's not going to go bad. It's an MRE. You could sell basically everything in this game if you go to the right spots. It's just, is it worth it? The door's open. This place is deadly. At least it used to be. I think they kind of fixed it. You used to walk out of the buildings and just get freaking pummeled by the wind and get killed. Now you'll just get knocked out for about a minute and then you'll revive yourself. But there's like her. I think this is probably the windiest place on all of Walla. I mean, it's pretty windy on Walla, but for some reason right here, it's just insane. Oh, insane window. I'm not taking any more flares either. You know what, I could. I mean, they're 18 credits each, but just at some point, you got to be like, how many flares do I need? I want to leave as much room on the ship for the better paying items. Ooh, hey, loot. Hey, backpack. Oh, I don't have a chest piece for it. It doesn't fit, but we're gonna take it. That has to go on a heavy armor torso piece. I have a light one on. There's light, medium, and heavy. And that's a backpack for a heavy torso. Which is like the Gray Cat arrows and ADPs and what's the name of those? Citadels. Stuff like that. You'll see it in the item description. It says heavy armor. But we're gonna go back to Bajini. Drop a bunch of this stuff off. And get going on our next mission. Look at that, 3,000 credits. Man, I remember when I first started playing, it was way harder to make money in this game. it was super hard. Oh my god. I don't even remember what the original delivery missions paid. I think they topped out at like 8,000 for like the higher tier ones. And we didn't have like bunker missions and stuff like that. We had just weird go out to the mining outpost and bring them a battery mission. It was so weird. Oh, wrong button. Missions like that, bounty hunting, we always had that. That seemed to be like the first mission they put in. That and the batteries. Just get people out there exploring the planets and moons after they finally got them in the game, after we were stuck at Port Olisar forever, and the other station that used to be there was Cryastro. It's not there anymore. Neither of them are there anymore. Let's clear out our ship. Let's go sell some stuff, and then we'll get started on the next mission. I want to show you guys, like, kind of early about selling. All right, let's filter these first. Armor, move all. Undersuits, don't have any clothing. Move all. Weapons. I want to stack these before I move them. Make it easier. So when you stack them, you can sell them in big bunches. All right, so we got 27 of those, 3 of those. I don't know why I can't stack these cyans. Whatever, I'm gonna just leave one in the ship anyway, so. Move all, but I wanna actually leave one in the ship as a backup. But sometimes I lose them. I don't know how. They go flying off my hands at the most inconvenient time. And, oh, I thought I left. Oh, I must have left it at the station. No big deal. I got plenty of food. Look at it. I got, like, enough food to last a week. Literally. Before I'd have to stop. What's this stuff? Golden Medmons and OC or whatever it's called. Oza. I'm gonna leave 2 of those in the ship. Those are just cool little snacks to have. The Medmons are good too. They fill you up and hydrate you pretty well. We're just gonna head over to the cargo deck. All right. Our spawn is set here. We're gonna head to the cargo deck and the Galleria, and we're gonna sell all our stuff at those two places. Guess we'll head to the cargo deck first. Before we start selling anything, I'm gonna see if I can find a turtle. Give me a turtle. I want a turtle. I need a turtle on this account. Out of the way, buddy. Out of the way. Out of the way. You're always here when I'm trying to get through. Yes, I found a turtle. Yay! His name's Tony the Turtle. I'm gonna keep him forever. All right. I have no place to put him in the Aurora, so he's gonna have to stay here until I get a better ship. How much is a cutter costing game? Like 700,000? Cutter's an actually a great ship. Great starter ship. It's got a huge gas tank. A lot of storage. It's got 4 SKU of storage. It's got a bed you can log in and out of. So does the Aurora, though, but doesn't have as much storage. All right, we're going to sell this hat. I started out with 3,000 when I got here. Oh man, this helmet used to be worth more. I guess since they're subscriber items, they're only giving you one credit for them. So I'm just gonna sell them anyway for one credit. I don't care. Ventra gloves, you're going. I don't need you. Ventra blue. ATI jacket, 680. All right, cool. Aero backpack, I'm gonna keep that. I don't like the color of those boots, so I'm gonna get rid of those. Get rid of these tough light boots. I'm not going to sell the Matisse shoes because I'm actually going to haul those over to Orison to get more money. Because you only get 120 for them here. Over at Orison, you get 440 credits. And the same with the Umbro suit. 390 credits here, but you go to Orison, you get 1.4K for them. So I'm going to wait till I have like maybe 10 or 15 of them, load them up on the ship and fly out there. So it's just worth while on the trip, and I'm taking the shoes with me too. And then I think it looks like everything else is just food. Oh, multi tools. All right, let's sell them. That one's worth 180. You're gone. 260. Okay, we're gonna sell all the ones worth money. We're gonna keep the ones that are worth one credit, because they do the same function. Here we go. The lifeguard medical attachments, 100 each. I have five of them. Look at that, 525 credits. Orbit mining attachment, sell it, max it out. We got three. That's another 588. Orbit mining. How many do I got of these? Right, I want to keep one. I think I sold one. Yeah, I sold one. Okay, minus one. There we go. Harvester tools, tractor beams. How many I got here? Two, sell them. Those are credits. How many I got here? Two, sell it. I only need like one or two of those things, so. How many I got there? Two, all right, we're not gonna sell that one. How many I got on the other one? Two, all right, sell those. So I got two tractor beams left, and I got a bunch of multi-tools. I'm just gonna quick sell, because I don't need so many. Even though they are only worth one credit. I guess I'll keep like three, just to be safe. One, two, three, and then this and that, and that's a fact. Jack. Backpacks, got one. Footwear, three pairs of Matisse jackets, drinks, foods, personal weapons and attachments. All right, this is all stuff I got rid of. Oh, how much did I make? I had 3,000. Look at that, I made 5,235 credits just selling the stuff I got from those two stations. And I got armor and a backpack, which I could also sell. And plus I have more stuff to sell taking those outfits over to Orison. So I think my progression is gonna be upgrade the Aurora when I go to Orison. And then from there, I don't know how much money I need to upgrade an Aurora. Probably not much, it's all size one. Probably like 100K, if even. All right, let's go do the next mission. Protect site trial contract. Should I do it? It's 15K right there. I only have, I'm going to do it. Why not? It'll be interesting. I only have a pistol with one extra mag. I can always pick up a weapon when I get there. I'm hoping the AI is working pretty well. Maybe I'll get some assistance from the security guards. Or I may just die and lose everything. We'll find out. I'm gonna scan for boxes. You never know if you're gonna find a box or not around here. I like how they highlight ships and turrets now. That's nice when you do a scan. Eventually, we're gonna be able to kind of scan from our mobi glass and see through walls and stuff, like if people are on the other side or mission objectives. I'm not sure how I feel about that, but... Alright, I can do this mission because, like, I have enough money to claim the Aurora if I need to. Alright, I got some, Uh-oh, I don't have an extra magazine. I forgot to equip it! Oh, no! And there's 10 hostiles remaining. I hear him arguing. Here we go. Medical stuff. I definitely want to take this stuff with me. Weapon. Ooh, I got this weapon too.
Look alive.
Oh no.
Be right back.
Keep an eye out. I want to see what the fuss is.
For some reason I can't carry both on my back. But hey, finding this weapon is like finding gold when you're, I got nothing. This is like a evaluation mission. And they gave me a Demco. I like it. I like it a lot. There's a guy right there. I have called the arms on, right? I'm just not getting the money, huh? Lucked out there. All right. Holy shit. Okay, I'm gonna go put this on the elevator because I'm taking it with me. I don't have any backpacks, so I'm gonna have to just make the best use of actions here. So we're gonna place this on the elevator. And then we're gonna run and grab other weapons. I don't remember what else was in this box. I was so like, hey, a Demco. You know what? I hate the arms I have on. I'm going to put those on instead. There we go. Oh, this only has 72 rounds in it. They must not have infinite ammo anymore. When the NPCs are using them, because normally they'd be all full up. Yeah, I only got one spot to put a weapon on my back since it's light armor. So I'm just gonna take what I can, get as much ammo as I can. I need to get a backpack. I can't pick that up. All right, let's I'd really like to have a backpack. All right, we're gonna place this next to this one. And when I go upstairs, I'll grab them and run to the ship. But I definitely want to get one of these pistols. I have to make a couple trips to the ship. I think there was another vest upstairs. They're definitely worth taking. These crease jackets aren't worth anything. The one with the snake and the nine on them. But these vests worth 2,400 credits each. So they're definitely worth taking. We got plenty of time though. Anything good? Anything good? Anything good? The Balor helmets are worth good money. I think they're worth like 1,400 each. And that one didn't spawn either when I dropped it out of inventory. Okay. So, oh, there we go. All right. I should probably take an armor set with me too, from one of the nine tails. The helmets on these dead guys are worth good money, especially the heavy armor guys. They're worth like over 1,000 each. I mean, you could get super rich just going around collecting helmets. And vests. And rock and roll t-shirts. Rock and roll t-shirts aren't worth anything. They're just cool. They look cool while you're doing stuff. So I got an ADP core that I can wear for that backpack I have back at Bajini. So I'm going to take a heavy armor set. I guess I'll take... I don't know what I'd like better. I'll take this one. Can't beat the original. I'll dump that in the ship as well. And then I have an extra set of armor in case I do get killed and I need something to wear. Get his stuff off and into inventory. And he took up half the inventory with that one outfit. Thank you for your service. I got plenty of time. Plenty of time. I could probably even do nothing for like a couple minutes and still get out of here in time. All right, 69%. Ha ha ha. Carry a weapon and a box. Or two weapons. Holster that one. Gotta take you. Man, I got like more than enough weapons to last me forever now. But now that I have cash, I can actually buy stuff. But I want to keep a reserve in just in case I have to like do something weird. Like a medical rescue. It's 15,000, you know? That you gotta pay. If you can't afford to pay it, I don't know what happens. I never even bothered to find out. I should have enough credits now for a medical rescue though. I don't think the helmet's very protective here against the cold. Let's see. Negative 30. He should be fine. Okay. It takes so long in the Aurora just to get to the planet. Usually it's like a 3 second, 3 or 4 second jump. It took like 15 seconds here. This game's so beautiful. I can't get over it. It just never gets old. been playing this game for 9 or 10 years, and it's just amazingly freaking gorgeous still, and it keeps getting better. It looks so different back in the day. It's not even funny. I look at all the old videos from way back when, and it was like the best graphics were like 720p, and it was just so bad. So bad. All right, I'm going to empty out the ship. I think I'm going to pull my armor off too, because I want to go do a eavesdropping mission. So we're gonna leave everything here in local, just in case we do die, we don't lose anything. It's the way you got to play it. All right, I left everything here. I'm going to take the pink undersuit, wear that. And I guess this helmet. Why not? It's throwaway. Okay. My throwaway armor. If I survive, I'll sell it anyway. So, mercenary. Protect site. Clear claim jumpers. I don't have any east. Okay, well, crap. Okay, I'll take this, I guess. Because I don't have any eavesdropping missions. And I guess I'll put some armor back on. I guess I'll take this. And Arclight. So I'll take an FS9. The Arclight pistol. The ammo for them. I guess I'll take some food just in case I do get stranded. And a multi-tool. So I can haul some stuff out of the bunker. I'll make another 15,000, hopefully. Let's see how much money I have now. Plus, I have all this stuff to sell here. It's really easy to make money in this game, people. I've talked to people who don't make any money, and I don't know how they're not making money. You can literally just make money at the spaceport, honestly. Just selling medical gowns. I mean, not a lot, but you can make 500 credits easily. That could be enough between getting your ship repaired and refueled and not. All right, with the backpack, I should be able to loot a bunch of crap down in the bunker. I want to test out if boxes will fit underneath there. The ones you can buy, the one SKU boxes. I'm sure someone's already tried it. I just don't know. Maybe I'll save that for the next episode. This one's already running pretty long. Where are we at? 24,000. I'll have about 40,000 after this. I guess I'll go to 50,000 credits on this mission. Oh, you scan for boxes when you're coming into the bunkers because people's ships get blown up out here and they leave boxes all the time. I think the box generation system's not working properly because every time I die or my ship gets blown up, there's nothing in the box, even though I know there was a bunch of stuff in the ship. So, but you still can get a box for free. Boxes are super handy. That's why you always need a multi-tool with you to move boxes around. It's like essential gear, a multi-tool with a tractor beam. At least MedPens. All right, we got two allies left. I don't think you can get any money for the sawtooth knife, but the FSK knife. Oh, wow. Look at all this stuff. The FSK knife is worth like 600 credits alone. Anything good? Get like 2,000 for these sniper rifles. I'm here to loot. I'm not really too interested in the mission, but I will get to them eventually. Best thing is to loot while you don't even have a timer yet, because then you get all the time in the world to do it. But you always got to be aware of those bad guys coming for you. Dang, could I miss him anymore? He was flying over the thing. I wonder if it was desync that caused me to miss so much. Or just my aim. Let's see that again at super slow-mo, Howard. Five baddies left. Four. Anything good? Hey, I'll take that helmet. Take the ammo. You steal ammo, you never have to buy it. See how I like to loot before the timers run out? I'm definitely gonna take one of these guards with me too, because I like their outfits. They got a nice setup with the Karnas too. And then just proceed to loot until your little heart's content. When you have no money, loot everything. I just saw a shadow move past here. That was so weird. I thought someone else was in the bunker. Like, even like those little medical pens and stuff, those add up. These face masks on the Ninetales, these ones right here, they're not worth anything. Don't even bother with them. But this is also like gear you can use later. You don't have to buy. You just keep it stored somewhere at your home port, and then you're like, oh yeah, well, cool. I got ammo. I got armor. I got, you know. Oh, mine. Thank you. Alright, I got a rail gun. And I'm gonna head up to the ship, do a load, and then come back down. And you know what? I'm just gonna put it on the elevator and then go up after I'm done. I need to get a box. I could have made so much more money. Like, these rifles, you can get for like 2,000 a piece for them over at Everest Harbor. At the armor store. You bring a box down, you just fill up the box, you take it out there, you got 100K easily. There's plenty of time. Go down again if I want. Let's see how much room I got left in the ship. All right, one more trip down and then I'm out of here. It's a few extra 1,000 credits, you know? P4, always a good gun to take because you can get good money for it, like I said. Take it over to Everest. I'm going to do the same thing with the P4s that I do with the Umbra suit. Just keep them in storage so I have a bunch of them. Load up the ship, take them over to Everest, and sell them all. Make really good money, you know, when you got like 40 or 50 of them in your ship. And that adds up really quick. I don't think this shotgun's worth much, but I'm just gonna grab it and see if I can find anything else better. This box was in here before. Oh, yeah. Bye-bye. Forget that shotgun. I got an F-55 now. See, look at that. Trip down made a big difference. If you don't know what an F-55 is, it's basically a minigun. It's just so fun to shoot. All right, we're out of here. My handgun goes brrrr. All right. All right, so we're gonna take this caterpillar mission. Not gonna get much for it, but hey, I'm still gonna put everything in local inventory except a pistol, or not a pistol, but a rifle. I guess I'll keep my armor on since I'm not gonna get in any trouble, hopefully. It said lost in space. I guess, I don't know. It's on the planet, but we're gonna go. Who is targeting me? I really wish they hadn't got rid of the return target. Used to be hit 4 and you could see who was targeting you. Oh, I really don't want them to bring in a Cutty Black, because they're so bugged right now that they're just like, you can't even do any damage to them, or it takes forever. And I am in such a crappy ship that I'll never get through their bug. It's like impervious to blast or fire or whatever. Yeah, good loot. Stuff I can sell. This is what I don't like about this whole walk up the ship stairs on this thing. Just not good. This side might be better. But if you're on uneven ground, it's almost impossible to get back in your ship. All right. I see the spaceport now through the clouds. I'm gonna leave everything in the ship, so I can just sell it from the ship. And then I'm gonna take the box down to the area center and then head over to probably Cubby Blast. Oh, you know, I don't think I have much in the ship, do I? Because I dropped it all off it. Let's see what's in the vehicle. Just stuff I wanna keep. Okay, well, I can sell what's in my backpack then. Oh no, oh no, oh no.
Want your company?
What the? Oh, okay, cool. I was on the highway. I don't know what happened. Oh my God. I didn't do anything. I was just standing there. I think I got caught up with the tram. Servers are always so bad when Jump Town's going on. It blows my mind just how awful it makes the game. And I know that's why they run it, because they want to test it under all kinds of different stresses. We did Jump Town earlier today, and it was a mess. But they got them at new locations now. The locations aren't optimized. They need to figure out what's wrong with them. And they need to test the servers under load. So that's, you know, that's why they run Jump Town. But it still sucks. I'm just gonna stay ahead. Stay back here. Caution, edge ahead. I'm surprised I survived that. Next bus will be here in about half a minute. There it is. I'm gonna put the C-54 in local inventory so I can sell it. Otherwise, I can't sell it. But I'll keep everything else in my backpack. I think I'm gonna spend a little bit of money on a FS9 ammo. Just get like 6 of them or something. Cause I'm not really finding much. Not yet, anyway. As fast as he'll run, we're carrying a box. That's hilarious. We need more landing pads up there, like balconies to land on and do missions and drop off stuff. Not just on the rooftops, but on like the sides of the building. We made it. All right. First thing I'm gonna sell is that C-54 that I have in local inventory. And then I'll sell everything from my backpack. All right. And then this stuff's not worth anything, huh? Let's see how much money I got. All right, we hit 50,295 credits, and we got a ton of stuff to sell up at Pagini. I'm gonna call it here for the first video. It's a long video. I'm gonna have to edit this down, but that's how these things go. That's how these zero to hero ones work.
Folks,
let's check the total right now. 50,284. We're gonna start there. I'm gonna buy some ammo on the next video at the beginning, and we're gonna go out and see if we can get to, I don't know, 200,000 next episode. And you guys let me know what you think. The should it be a ship, should it be a credit amount, you know? Like I said, don't want it to be a super high amount, because I don't want this to be like 100 episodes long. You know, maybe 10 episodes. Or maybe I just see how much I can make in 10 episodes. I don't know. I love you guys. I'm out of here. CyberWar signing off. I have to do a lot of editing on this thing. It's so long. We're at 2.5 hours in. Dun, 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 dun. Love you guys. I'll see you guys soon. I'm trying to get this down to about an hour. I'll see you guys later. Bye.